It is estimated that 8 out of 10 people desire to write a book. Even more interesting is that only 5% of that 8 out of 10 will actually ever publish their book. And furthermore, only 0.0025% of that 5% will sell over 1,000 copies of their book. I found those statistics to be very, very interesting, but I can see why they're somewhat discouraging to people who want to become an author. But just like anything in life, completion of a project and staying true to your goals and staying true to your vision is something that requires a lot of hard work, persistence, and focus. And so just to kick off this author series or this series of videos where I explain not only my award-winning author journey, I just want to share with you how I became an author and just offer some proactive and inspirational advice to help you to become an author as well. So without further ado, let me explain to you how I became an author, because it was not something that was expected. It was something that was unexpected. And initially I resisted this idea of becoming an author. But as I really focused and look back on my journey, I realized that I had a very, very powerful story to tell the world. And I realized that if I didn't tell my story to the world, I would be doing the world a disservice. Isn't that pretty interesting? So let me tell you a little story. My name's Craig, and I'm originally from Cincinnati, Ohio. And growing up, I moved around a lot as a kid because of my father's job. And getting used to moving to different cities and getting enrolled in different schools and having to meet new people was very difficult, but I had to learn quickly how to adapt myself to these new surroundings. But what kept me really grounded throughout all this change was athletics. And I went to multiple different high schools, but I was good enough to get a Division I opportunity to play college football down in Alabama. And my sophomore year playing football, I tore my hamstring. And this injury set me on a spiral of depression, and I almost dropped out of school. But this amazing woman, my Spanish professor at the time, Mrs. Crocker, convinced me to study abroad in Costa Rica before I made that fateful decision. And thank God she intervened in my life, because going to Costa Rica completely opened up my mind to another possibility of not only living in another country, but potentially working and maybe starting a business in another country. I became so addicted to travel that when I came back to Alabama, I was really refreshed, switched my major to entrepreneurship, double minored in Spanish and international business, and I also started DJing to make ends meet. And so I used some of those proceeds from my DJing company to go to Spain for 3 months to study abroad. And that really locked in this international business vision for me and my life. Wound up graduating in 4 years, but I didn't know what to do with myself. So my parents convinced me to go get my MBA because they knew if I went into the workforce, I'd never go back to school. So I moved to Tampa, knocked out my MBA in a little less than a year, which is pretty crazy because it's typically a 2-year program. And I was figuring out what were my next steps. Interviewed in New York and San Francisco at big tech companies, but didn't get a job offer. But life changed when I met a Peace Corps recruiter at a Chipotle in Manhattan, and she convinced me to apply because she's like, you're fluent in Spanish, you're entrepreneurial, you'd make the perfect Peace Corps volunteer. And so I got the opportunity to move to Peru to do economic development consulting, and it was just an amazing opportunity. But during my time working in the Peace Corps, I was also teaching youth entrepreneurship. And I ran across this professor who was also a distiller. And after classes, he would teach me how to distill. And I got really good at it. And I basically took the products, the liqueurs that I was making with this professor, and I'd give them to a lot of my clients that I was consulting with in Peru. And I built up this massive following of individuals, and that inspired me to immigrate back to Peru by myself to open up one of the country's first branded craft distilleries. And the project was incredible. In less than 9 months, we got 4 different products to market. I grew so fast that I had to approach my landlord to not only extend my lease, but also gain another piece of their property to expand my operations. And when I did that, they ultimately confessed that they did not own the property. And essentially, I had signed a fraudulent lease, which made me an illegitimate tenant at my own space, which was crazy. And so I had to close my business because I had no legal right to be there. And that was like my first big attempt with failure. But as I wrote my book, fail just means a first attempt in learning. And so I wound up moving back to the US. I got a job in project management, didn't really like it, launched another startup venture, which had a little bit of traction and success, but I had to liquidate that outcome after my partner and I split. And I moved back to Ohio in 2019. And it's been 10 years since I've been back to the state. And it was crazy because I didn't know what I was gonna do. I was kind of lost. I was trying to figure out how I was gonna support myself. And I was just networking one day and I was telling people this story that I'm telling you. And I wound up running across a publisher who's like, hey man, you have a book inside of you. Maybe you should work with me and my publishing company to share your story with the world. And I resisted that. I'm like, who am I? I'm just, you know, a guy from Ohio. And I just happened to travel the world and start a business and serve in the Peace Corps and be a Division I athlete and be a DJ and, you know, sell, you know, my blockchain application to embassies. Like, I did all these things, but who am I? I'm just a regular guy. And as I really sat down and I started to capture my thoughts on paper, like this book idea transmuted from a project into a calling. And when you open up my book, Burdens of a Dream, the dedication is as follows. This book is dedicated to all those who will dare to answer their callings, to abandon the status quo, follow the road not taken, and discover the person they're truly meant to become. And as much as I was writing those words to my potential readers, I was really writing those words to myself, because I had to answer my calling to abandon the status quo, follow the road not taken, and discover the person I was truly meant to become. And the person I was truly meant to become was not just this athlete, not just this entrepreneur, but I was destined to become an author as well. Because I had a hell of a story to tell. I just didn't see it myself. Somebody had to look at me and unlock that potential to give me the courage and the confidence to share my story with the world. And so as I'm speaking these words to you and to whoever's watching this video, you too, you have a powerful story to tell the world. But are you going to have the confidence and the courageousness to share it? It's kind of crazy to think about all that's happened since my book came out March 31st of 2020. Writing my book, Burdens of a Dream, literally changed my life, because after I launched this book, I realized that there was so much more to being an author. As an entrepreneur, I took this opportunity not just to write a book, but also to create a business around my book. And when my book came out, I was like, okay, what am I going to do with this? So I wound up launching my coaching business and creative agency, Creative Craig LLC, tongue twister right there, which has opened up this whole new window of opportunities for me. And it's just incredible, like all the people that I've met since writing my book. I got to travel around the US. I did an East Coast book tour, West Coast book tour. I've been on countless podcasts and radio interviews. I've launched this YouTube channel after publishing my book and opening up my company. I've gotten invited to be a part of different groups and memberships because of this opportunity to write this book. Like, my life completely changed after I decided to not only to write my thoughts down on paper, but to publish it and share it with the world. And like I said, it's difficult to put into words like how much my life has changed for the better since I answered my calling to abandon the status quo, follow the road not taken, and discover the person I was truly meant to become. And so you too can experience this, but you have to stick with it. You have to stay the course. Like, there's a reason why only 2 out of 10 people actually write a book. There's a reason why only 5% of that 2% actually, I mean, only 5% of those 2 out of 10 people actually publish. There's a reason why only 0.0025% of that 5% who publish actually get to sell over 1,000 copies, which I'm privileged to have done. And I also won an award for the best entrepreneurship book of 2020, sponsored by the American Book Fest. Like, this is a legitimate book. This is my first time ever writing a book, and I'm so excited. Like, I'm stuttering and, you know, fumbling over words, and I'm not going to edit any of this out because, like, this is genuine how I feel about this. So I say all this to you to inspire you to sit down, capture your thoughts on paper, publish your work, and share it with the world. It's not easy, but in the following videos, I'll be giving you a lot of tips and tricks to help you position yourself to become an award-winning author, just like I am. So my question for you today is, what is preventing you from sharing your story with the world? I'm really curious to hear your thoughts, and please be sure to drop your comments below. Furthermore, if you want to become the entrepreneur of your life, you can begin this process today by subscribing to this channel. Also, please be sure to click the notification bell to be alerted for whenever new content is uploaded. See you next week.